Chief Magistrate, case not moving to Crown Court. Scumbags. Scumbags, mate. Aren't they? 41 images, 7 of them in the worst category ever. And they're keeping them at the magistrate for sentence. What does that mean? Less than 12 months. Probably community service. I'm telling you, he's getting community service. He's getting community service, mate. And this shows you, this is like... This is like... it's just another Savile. Only this time, you've covered it up better. He's not the only one, mate. How old is he now? How are you, Sila? Are you good? Solution, Michael Wilson. That Hugh, the news reporter. He's admitted having 41 images, including 7 of the most serious category A's. And now the magistrates have decided to keep it in the magistrate court. So basically what they're saying there is, this case is not severe enough for the Crown. You know what you're witnessing here? Masonry. This is what you're witnessing right now with this event, what's going on. Masonry. You want to know who the dark forces are? You want to know who the people are controlling the puppets? Masonry. It's right before your eyes, mate. Oh, who's the secret darkness? It's the Masons, mate. They control a whole thing well. And you look past it, don't you? But you know when you had the two scapegoats from Great Britain going to America and you've got them walking down that hall and all you've got is the black and white diamond floor. This is all the symbolism that you're on about. It's not paranoid. It's not a conspiracy theory. It is what it is, mate. And what did he do? You know, how many families have been murdered this year and last year? I'm not just talking about family member. I'm talking about family. Full family's gone. What did he do? Oh. Look how many families are getting wiped by one of their own. So you'll have a sibling and just wiping his brothers and his mother and that also. You'll have the dad. Do you understand what I'm saying? Seeing how many's happening? They're not doing all about it, are they? So just think about all the death to do with violence in the last 5 years. Have they done anything about it? Have they tried to do anything about it? Have they tried to prevent it getting worse? Or did he just turn up when it's time to punish? They're just turning up when it's time to punish, aren't they? They're not preventing, they're not stopping the flow. They're encouraging it. Might be hard to believe when you're caught up in your nice 5-bedroomed house and your full-time job and might be hard to believe because you're fucked up. You're caught up in that curriculum you have been all your life. From school to where you are now, you have just been caught up in a little box all your life. Need to step outside that box, mate, and have a good look around at what's going on. Women and children getting murdered all over the gaff. Are they trying to prevent it? Are they opening women's refuge? Have they brought in laws to make it legal for women to carry pepper spray? Have they? No. Do you understand what I'm saying? These are all preventable measures that can protect your women and children. And why aren't they implicating them? Why aren't they implementing them, I mean? Do you understand what I'm saying? Cunts, mate. Let's keep it positive. Stay away from them fucking protests. You're doing what they want you to do. Look, they need to identify who's for and who's against. For what they're implementing, this European agenda, they don't want people with a unique identification. They don't want you waving your English flag. So they need to know, you know, where's the pockets of resistance? Who is going to be the pockets of resistance in the future? And he's identifying you. Basically, that's what you're doing. You're putting yourself out there, letting them know that in the future, when we're implementing this, the only people that are going to resist to the hilt is that group. We need to identify them now so we can put a stop to it before they even try to do anything to us. So in all that group that's going to these protests with the weasel, you'll have your nan, your granddad, you know, they're not asked about them. They're not asked about them. But within that big, massive group, you will have pockets of men who are deep in it, mentally, just like Robinson. And they'll know these are the orchestrators of the resistance. These are the teams that are going to, you know, gain movements and start generating unity amongst the culture. Do you understand what I'm saying? And they'll just shut you down in all different little mad ways. Separate yous, isolate yous. Some in jail, some people's heads up their ass because the bill's gone to fuck or the bank's playing up, or just all little mad distracting tactics on all of yous. Just stay away from it, mate, trust me. Compose yourself, prep yourself. If you think this country's going to where you think it's going, get yourself in the gym on a daily. Start prepping yourself for what's coming. Look after yourself. Look after your little family. Look after your community. Get yourselves strong, fit and ready for your cause. What's your cause? If you're a family man, you should only have one cause. Protecting your family. Isn't it? Now, if the cause means your cause is protecting your family, and in that same thing, it means you've got to protect the family next door as well, and the family next door as well, then so be it. What are you protecting, screaming your head off outside Downing Street? Nothing, mate. You're putting yourself at risk. As I say early on, the government, that's one risk, facial recognition and all. That's just one risk. The other risk, the main risk, is a plant pot jumping amongst us and letting something go. Mightn't be one plant pot, might be three or four of them. Do you understand? Just all going in at once. Your ma's gone there thinking she's had a peaceful protest. Now her head's gone. What are you going to do? Are you going to run out and blame the Islamic community? You are, aren't you? Are you going to blame Steer Karma, whatever his name is? You are, aren't you? You're going to blame everything about the country except for the rat that took you there, aren't you? That's how blind yous are, yous people that follow weasels. Just avoid it, mate. You've got, what you've got as well, you've got some groups of football, I don't even call them hooligans, just football men who are passionate about the team. You've got a lot of these groups attending these places, but they haven't got the same ideology as that weasel. And there's a lot of these groups of football supporters from up and down the country that are feeling, you know, anxious, angry, frustrated about what's going on in the country. And they're attending these events. Yes, that's right. And they don't want to. But it's like that's the only movement that's repping it. It's like, that's why you've got nanas, sisters, aunties, brothers. There's not another movement that's voicing what they need to voice. It's just him. And that's the the monopoly he's got on the whole thing, if you like. Do you understand what I'm saying? If there was another individual screaming what they know, what they feel, what we representing them, they'd all follow him. If there was a proper leader screaming, wanting to protect the women, wanting to protect the children, driving it for the right political reasons, not wanting division, understanding unity for the children, because if you haven't got unity amongst the adults, you've definitely not got unity amongst the children. You know what poisonous fuck-ups are like. Can you imagine the ideology of Tommy Robinson's kids? Can you imagine it? And then could you imagine, let's say, Andrew Chowdhury's kids? They're never mixing. Ever. Do you understand what I'm saying to you? And that's the future. Do you want these kids right across the country growing up divided? Do you want your kids going to the five-a-side pits and it's going off because there's a Muslim team over there or there's an African team playing footy there? Do you want this shit to all come back to the forefront? It's not that long ago. 70s, 75, 80s. You know, that's what it was like. Do you want it back there? That's where they want it. They've seen the strength when you're unified. They don't want that. The government can't have that. The king can definitely not have that. The king cannot have a unified country. Why? Because when a unified country gets unhappy and doesn't like what they're seeing, it's on. And there's all big King Charles can do about it, except kill us all. It's the only thing they can do when we're unified is put the army on us and shoot us all dead. I know it sounds far-fetched, doesn't it? It is very far-fetched. Why? Because we're all divided. It's never going to fucking happen. Cherry B. Tommy Robinson. Take your protest to the front doorstep of King Charles. Keir Starmer can't do nothing for you, mate. All you're doing is putting your own kind at risk. Your own communities are going to get the backlash of that protest. Your own people are going to be getting placed in prison because they want to support you and your bullshit. You're not even batting an eyelid for them. Kept on chatting your shite, inciting it more and more and more, hoping that you'd get the boil over you wanted, but it never happened. Unity overtook division, that's why it never happened. But you're back for another go now, and this is your intention. You nearly had it last one. The whole country nearly erupted, never to return to the way it was. Do you understand what I'm saying? It was the unified people within the country that prevented it going that way. Here he is, second time round, same intention. He knows this protest, there's not going to be a madness there by his people. They'll have the flags, they'll have the provocative words, they'll scream Muslim, anti-Islamic stuff and Christ is king and all this, you know, bringing the religious division right to the forefront again. Do you understand what I'm saying? He knows nothing's happening. It's what happens afterwards. It's what happens on the back of it. Like I said earlier on, you've got twisted people, regardless of what faith they're in. And when they see these protests going across the news, right across social media, with anti-Islamic slogans and this about Muhammad and that about this faith and that about that and that about because it's all negative, these little mad people just pop out in their communities and go, is that how you feel about me and my Allah? And he's not like the majority. He's just like me. Twisted and had enough. Do you understand what I'm saying? And that's what happens. Soon as you get one of these little twisted kids running out and going bang on whatever he's done, that ignites the right wing. It ignites the division. It has people coming in the community smashing mosques up. It has all this, and that's exactly where he's leading it again. Just don't go. I'm not going to keep on talking about it. Just don't go. Put your energy on something that's good for you and your community, not into some little weasel that's going to hit the fences. It's going to hit the fences. It's going to leave you all in a mess. He's going to get a million or two off you. He's going to get you sponsoring this, sending funds for this, hitting that link to watch this, make himself a millionaire again. And then he's back, off the scene again. He's only back on the scene because he went bankrupt. You know, you've seen what he went like when he had all this funding coming in off you. Went quiet, didn't he? Just happy, popping up every so often, having a rant, keeping the flow coming, keeping his addiction going, keeping his gambling addiction and his cocaine addiction flowing. It's all she's done for him. You just made a cokehead with an ego through the roof think he's got an ego to heaven now. He thinks he's extra special now. Do you understand what I mean? He can't walk nowhere by himself. He can't. If he was a man of the people, you'd go anywhere and no one would attack you. No one would give you shit. No one would give you anything. They'd want your support. Can you have a photo? Can you have it? He can't get that nowhere. He'll get it at a BNP party or an NF party or something like that. He'll be a hero. Anywhere else in the UK, he's looked at like a piece of shit, mate. Honest, there's about 800,000 people in the whole country that'll... Oh, there's Tommy! And he'll run away, thinking it's some kid with a milkshake or something.